C2 Identity supports the import of users and groups from an LDAP server. You can utilize our export tool to migrate LDAP user and group information to C2 Identity via a single CSV file upload. This empowers C2 Identity to serve as the central hub for your company's identity and access management needs. Alternatively, with C2 Identity LDAP Sync, you can automatically synchronize users and groups from Synology LDAP server to C2 Identity while maintaining current LDAP server operations. Once complete, administrators will be able to more efficiently allocate permissions for cloud applications and devices. In this video, we will guide you on how to import or synchronize user and group information from LDAP server to C2 Identity. You will find the timestamp of each section in the video description. Sign in to C2 Identity and go to Users. Click on Import Users Groups. Choose your directory server source. If your directory service is provided by a non-Synology LDAP server, please select From General LDAP Server. In this video, we will select From Synology LDAP Server as an example. Specify your LDAP server IP address, BaseDN, BindDN, and BindDN password. You can find this information at the Synology LDAP server package on your Synology NAS. Download the export tool on your computer. Launch PowerShell and enter the path of the export tool, then run it. Copy and execute the command shown in the Import User Group from LDAP Server window. The system will generate a CSV file in the same location as the export tool. Return to C2 Identity Admin Portal and press Browse to upload CSV file. Select the following options as needed. Overwrite duplicate users and groups. This allows duplicated items from LDAP Server to overwrite those in C2 Identity. All group and user information is replaced, including group membership relationships. Assign C2 Identity licenses to imported users. This assigns C2 Identity licenses to users imported from your LDAP directory. Administrators will be able to manage their access to local and cloud services and devices. Click on Import to import users and groups from your CSV file to C2 Identity. You can also assign device and application access permissions for imported user accounts and devices, allowing users to sign in with their original LDAP account permissions. Before you start, ensure that your device is connected to the internet and has permission to access your LDAP server. Verify that C2 Identity LDAP Sync is compatible with your device. Refer to the description field below for more information. In the C2 Identity Admin Portal, click on Directory Integration. Click on Integrate Synology LDAP. Select the option corresponding to your computer's operating system. In this video, we will select Run on Windows as an example. Download and install C2 Identity LDAP Sync. After installation is complete, right-click on the installed program and select Run as Administrator. Specify your LDAP server IP address, BaseDN, BindDN, BindDN password, and LDAP directory service port. The proxy will attempt to connect to your Synology LDAP server. You can find this information at the Synology LDAP server package on your Synology NAS. Specify the server name and the connection key provided on the setup page and click Connect. After establishing a connection, go back to C2 Identity. Click Approve. Select from the following options: Overwrite duplicate users and groups. This allows duplicated items from LDAP server to overwrite those in C2 Identity. All group and user information is replaced, including group membership relationships. Assign C2 Identity licenses to synced users. This assigns C2 Identity licenses to users synchronized with your LDAP directory. Administrators will be able to manage their access to local and cloud services and devices. Click Start Syncing. your LDAP information will be synchronized to C2 Identity immediately. You can also assign device and application access permissions for imported user accounts and devices, allowing users to sign in with their original LDAP account permissions. Note that user information in C2 Identity, except passwords, can't be directly edited. Passwords can be changed through the user portal, but other information such as names or groups must be edited through the LDAP server. To learn more about C2 Identity, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel and click the videos here to keep watching.